We are hanging out with Mayim Bialik, and we have decided to dissect a frog together. Because you can teach science.
You've done science.
I do. I have done that.
Yeah, and we're gonna learn at the feet of a master by dissecting
the frog.
I think
that's slightly overstated, but.
This is the frog we have.
We didn't get a real frog because if we had a real frog on this show, we would just be forced to eat it. Because that's what happens on this show. If you put something in front of us, we have to
eventually
start consuming
we will
it.
Eat it.
So, that, and also you're a vegan, so
yeah.
We're just like. We'll go plastic frog.
Thank you. Appreciate it. You can learn a lot from a plastic frog.
Yeah. Well, let's find out just what we can.
What do you have?
I have
a vision.
Yeah, that's convenient.
Are you going to hit us with that or point things out?
No, I'm going to point things out.
Okay.
Frog and frog.
Okay. Are we ready to get started?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I've got a whole kit here with sharp things.
Yes, you do.
Yes. Finally. Sharp things again.
As do I.
We'll need super sharp things.
Link
but,
doesn't know those
okay,
are all rubber.
I'm going to put this down. Okay. The first thing we need to do.
Is name him.
Okay. makes it a little bit harder to then cut him open, but go ahead.
This is Frandy. It's Randy, but with an F because he's a frog.
Mine is named Charles.
And Charles.
That's okay. My name, you jerk.
Yeah.
Is this some sort of voodoo thing that you're going to do here?
Well, maybe.
My middle name is Lincoln. I didn't make up Link. There's people always think when my name is Charles.
You don't have
I don't
to defend yourself.
It.
Don't defend
I'm also
yourself.
Not short. I'm 6 feet tall. Okay, let's get into this.
That's true.
He's very not short, though.
Right.
Is the
right.
Exactly. Yeah,
he is the problem.
It's just a,
yes.
All right. Please turn Frandy and Charles over. This is their ventral side.
Okay. Look at that. Made in China.
Wow.
Right.
Like all frogs.
First, we're going to look a little bit at the external anatomy of Frandy and Charles. Mm-hmm. Can you determine the sex of Frandy and Charles?
Female, definitely.
Why do you say that?
No penis.
No freeness is what they call it on a frog.
So, interestingly, you
don't tell me it's on the inside. Don't tell me they've got an internal penis.
You won't see it on the outside. This opening...
What a bummer for
I don't really like touching it with my finger, even though it's not real. This opening is called the cloaca.
Okay.
Oh, that's where everything comes out.
That everything goes in and out.
Yes. You want me to make it bigger?
What? No! All right.
That's where that thing is for.
Now, so that's the cloaca. So the way that there are external ways to sometimes determine if it's a male or a female.
You ask it.
or you sniff it.
No, it usually has to do with like the musculature.
Okay.
Males have different muscles. Males are generally smaller than females. We can't really tell about Frandy and Charles, but you can tell on the inside if it's a boy or a girl. Sometimes there's eggs. We'll get to that in a minute.
Let's get in there. I really want to get in there.
Okay, so hold on 1 second. One more thing. One more thing that's on our general when you dissect a frog. Please find the mouth and eyes.
Oh, this is going to be difficult.
Good.
Ding, ding, ding.
Eyes.
I found it.
Mouth. Great. I don't know why it's on the list, but it's a thing.
Okay.
Oh, dear.
Found the tongue.
Oh,
it's the tongue.
Oh, gosh.
I don't. Okay, well, let's cut the mouth open.
Cut the mouth open.
Well, it's hinged. So for this, you usually would use a scalpel. That's sharp.
I have a very sharp scalpel here.
Why are you holding it like that? It's pinned down.
Last time I was trusted with a sharp thing.
Oh, here we go. Oh, got it.
Oh, okay.
Popped it.
Great.
Okay.
Look at that. Gross. Gross.
It's not, okay, we don't use words like gross when we say that. Interesting.
Oh, that's interesting.
Look at that.
Exactly.
Brody.
Can you see teeth, tongue, or esophagus in there?
I can see a dotted thing, looks like a...
I think that's where the tongue's going to attach, because
like
it's a muscle.
Hand-painted toothpick.
I think I got a toothless frog. It must be an old one.
Let's see. Well, there's definitely no teeth in this one. I don't think they have teeth. Little ones. Okay. Next, we would like to lift and cut through the muscles and the breastbone. So we're going to remove the panel, as it were. Oh, okay, just like that.
Is that how it works on a real frog?
Not at all.
Pops right off like the hood of an Oldsmobile.
No, usually on a real frog, you'd make more of a kind of a T-shape and pin the flaps.
How are kids supposed to learn anything? Kids are going to be going out to frogs and just, and nothing's happening, Mom.
Okay.
There's a lot of blackness in here.
Yeah, there's a lot of blackness in there.
No. Frog's been eating
licorice. This is normally the time that you would be able to tell if it was a male or female. There are usually egg sacs, and they're quite prominent.
Are they black?
No, that's not the egg sacs.
What is the blackness?
That's the liver, I believe.
Okay, let me pop that off. I'm not going to use the knife for a while because...
You're scared of
okay, know so, thyself.
Well, what do you think is here at the... What do you think's here at the top?
That's a heart.
That is the heart.
I win.
That is the heart. So you can take off the liver. That's what I'm assuming we're going to do next.
Golly, I think this thing's got cirrhosis.
Remove the licorice patch.
It's not a...
Oh, wow, the heart came off with it. Look at
dear.
That.
Hold
Why
on.
Why do they got to have such a big liver?
Wait for it. I don't know. Hold on.
I think that's the testicle.
That's not the testicle. Hold on. These are the intestines, obviously.
Yeah.
Wait for it. Hmm. Interesting. Just like when you dissect a real frog, it looks nothing like the diagram.
Look, I got everything.
Oh, you just took it all out. Okay, great. So
now the hard part is putting it back and then breathing life into it.
Put it all on the side. Okay, once you took everything out, we can see those are the kidneys.
Well, dang, I haven't taken everything out.
Well, it's pretty easy.
Kidneys are in there.
Uh-huh.
That's all the vasculature.
This is a stomach.
The bladder's at the bottom.
Here's the stomach.
It looks stomachy.
It looks like it could be a human stomach.
Well, yeah, it's a you know.
It's a
chordate.
It's a chordate, man.
It's a chordate.
It's a chordate, of course.
The bladder is down by the cloaca. It serves as the receptacle for liquid waste before it is passed through the cloaca.
I love that part.
The remaining two removable parts are fat bodies.
Fat bodies.
Fat bodies.
This is a fat body.
I have a feeling that's a fat body.
I wonder if they eat that. Like people who eat stuff from frogs.
So this is just like insulation for the organs.
It's extra fat that they accumulate. And that's also one of the ways you can tell between males and females because they have different fat distribution.
And it's also probably the thing that we should eat because let's just face it. Now that I see it in front of me, I kind of want to eat it.
No, no.
Well, I feel like we've created a bowl, you know? It's like a soup bowl.
No.
Just kind of get your water and then out the cloaca.
Oh my God.
Does it come out there? Can you suck on it hard enough?
I'm giving it all I got, Captain.
It's not a real cloaca. It's not functional. I'm just gonna have to get in there.
I think we're done here.
All right, man, we learned a lot.
I learned so much. All right, kids, drink out of your frogs.
They're gonna take my doctorate back. That's what's gonna happen. They're gonna take away my PhD.
I've also eaten a worm's anus. It's the way to a woman's heart.
Okay, thanks to Mayim for getting science-y with us. You can watch Mayim in The Big Bang Theory. Also, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Mayim Bialik.
Taste. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. So you know what time it is.
You know what time it is.
Hi, I'm Ryan from Texas, and I'm in Baku, Azerbaijan. And it's time to spin the wheel of mythicality.
Thank you, Ryan. Remember to click the bottom link to watch today's episode from the beginning.
And click the top link to watch us use the science power, not lung power, to blow up balloons in Good Mythical More.
And to find out where the wheel of mythicality is going to land.
You earn yourself a Mythical merit badge or two, so get them at mythical.store.